get an oil bath here.
Where did I find not the big ratchets, but the medium sized ones and some extensions?
Top of my toolbox.
The top of your toolbox.
There we are. Doing 800 hour service. Getting ready to drain the finals. I'll break one of the top ones loose first. That way, relieves pressure out. I've taken the bottom one out first and got an oil bath. Because it builds pressure in there. Oops. Let that drain for a while. I'm getting the oil filter off. Doing an oil change on the Cat skid steer also right now, and Kubota's looking pretty good. Oil filter on that damn Cat is in a position you can't hardly get anything on, and it always tightens up to the point to where you totally destroy the filter getting it off. So Cat could take a little cue from Kubota on how to set up an easy service. Because this thing's pretty easy to service. That easy.
And somehow they need to have where you can pull the plate off the bottom and have a fucking drain plug. Like the Cat's got.
Try to get that in there without getting dust all over it. Yes, I'm putting a wrench on it, but I don't tighten it very tight with it. It's hard to get your hand in there to tighten it very much. Whoops. Yeah, got a little more than that. There we go. This I put pretty tight. Do not want that falling out. oil all over my glove. Horrible when you're doing an oil change and get oil on you. Definitely don't want one of those coming out. Yeah, we didn't have a video yesterday because somebody drove off yesterday morning and left their camera at home. So we just dug footings. It was boring. You wouldn't have liked it. Okay. Let it sit for a minute because the stuff's so thick. I'm afraid that, I don't know if it's true or not, but I'm afraid, yeah, it did, that pump it too fast, it'll come out the filler before it's actually full. Repeat the other side. I'm gonna give her a clean up. I change my finals pretty much every time I change my oil. And I change my oil every 150 hours, which is sooner than the book says to do it, but I figure oil's cheap, finals aren't. So fuel filter.
pick up 20 horsepower just by changing a fuel filter. Maybe not.
I'm gonna blow the radiators out now.
Sucky part. Bunch of dandelions over there at Jim's job, and it just all those little puffy tops. Felt like doing the demo stuff where I get the insulation in there and just clogs everything up.
Yeah, this is a filter off the cat skid steer.
Ready. Now this will probably pick 20 horsepower up. The Kubota one.
Okay. deal up at the my Kubota dealer, and worked great for blowing the radiators and the air cleaners out. Well, should get you one. There, clean air filter. Fire extinguisher out of the way. That's something somebody can give some suggestions on. I used to mount my fire extinguishers right here on the 121s. And these, everything's plastic. Plus, being right there, you'll hit your head on them. So, I have not found a good place to mount my fire extinguisher. So I wrap it up in a towel behind the seat. You know, good quick access. So luckily I've never needed it, but I did my old dump truck one day. My old 76. All the wiring caught on fire and it damn near burned to the ground. But, well, got those blown out. I always wore sheaths with water. I really am not impressed with the job of filtering that they do. They really don't, in my opinion, filter that well. And they're a bitch to get back in. There we go. There we go. Because the brochure says how great the cabin filter filters the air. And I haven't noticed it being that good. I think my 121's got less dust in the cab than these 40s do. Extinguisher back in place. You're missing something else too. There it is. There, we're back in business. Well, thanks everybody for watching. That's the extent of my 800 hour service. And I appreciate everybody watching. To me, this stuff should be boring to watch, but shit, I sit and watch hours of people changing oil and doing maintenance, so I guess it's a thing. So, everybody have a wonderful weekend, and we will catch you on Monday on a big project. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.